It's the NFL on EA Sports. As we see a team who left LA take on a team who came back home. It's gonna be a good one. And it's all up next.
If you're a freeway fan, we're just east of the 405. One of the modern jewels of the NFL. Beautiful SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. So good to have you here with us. Mike Tirico, Greg Olson getting set for a kickoff here. Greg, no matter how many ways we look at this game, it always comes down to one stat, doesn't it? How you taking care of the ball.
Yeah, it's just so crazy, Mike, that every single week, no matter how complex these matchups get and how many factors there are to determining who wins and who loses any game in the NFL, at the top of the list, the most important metric that everybody studies, can you protect the ball on offense and can you take it away on defense? And I don't think today's matchup is any different. Can you be aggressive and take care of the ball? And on defense, if you get your opportunity to take it away and give it back to your offense, you've got to make the play.
Here comes Amir Abdullah on the return. He'll be brought down right around the 25-yard line. The Raiders offense set to take over for the first time. They're led out by the man from Purdue, their quarterback, Aiden O'Connell.
Here's a guy that could be described as your very traditional, typical drop-back passer. We don't have a lot of them left in today's modern offense, but he can stand tall in the pocket, and he can throw it all over the field. But when it comes to operating NFL offense at a high level, he's got some growing to do. That's where his development and the next step has to come. Now, today is going to be a big opportunity for him to showcase, has that development started, and he can lead his team to a big win, we'll go a long way.
And a strong first down run, a pickup of 9, setting up second and short. They go play action. It's O'Connell. To find his running back, right. Taken down after a gain of 3, but that is good enough for a first down.
All right, so there's really 3 areas that a modern NFL running back has to excel at. Number 1, the traditional handoffs. Number 2, you have to be excellent and reliable in pass protection. And maybe bigger than all of them, you have to be at least serviceable out of the backfield in the passing.
Come to the line now on 2nd and 2. From the pistol, it's O'Connell. Had a quick throw there, but not on the same page with his target. That's incomplete. Now a 3rd and 2. He'll try to run for it. Here's White. And he's going to have the Raiders first down as they get 5 on 3rd and 2. Now give out of the gun. It's Madison. A gain of 4 as he's taken down. Here's a 2nd and 6. On the give, it's White. First and 10 from the 38-yard line. first down. A run with Madison. Not a lot on that one. He'll take it down to the 36. Hook him up on a second down and 8. Here's a give up the middle with White. And nothing on that one. Back to the line of scrimmage. And that is it.
Some nose guards in the 3-4 defense, Mike, are just asked to take up space and eat up blockers. But not this guy. He defeats his blocker and makes the tackle. That's playing the nose guard at the next level.
On play action, O'Connell. Complete.
The whole idea of the play action pass, Mike, is that you can slow the pass rush down enough that it allows longer, slower developing pass concepts to open up downfield. But in this case, they were on him so fast that by the time he got his head around, that ball needed to come out. There was no timing and ultimately led in an incompletion.
Carlson's kick is good. And the Raiders will take a 3-0 lead.
And that's a good drive right out of the gate. They're able to make some plays, move the ball down the field. I know they didn't get a touchdown, but that is a good positive result.
Three points on that opening drive. We'll see the response as the kick's away. Here's Smith to return it. That'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Rams led out by a Super Bowl champion, Matthew Stafford, second among all active passers in the NFL. Only Aaron Rodgers has thrown for more yards. Hard to believe, Greg, it's already season 16 for the man out of the University of Georgia.
Stafford was one of those guys, Mike, that I think through the first half of his career was probably the most underappreciated quarterback in the entire league. The talent was always undeniable. But what he was constantly discredited for was just the fact that he was on some really bad teams that were left to play really irrelevant football down the stretch. Immediately changed that narrative the second he joined a championship roster. Now, he's just trying to see if he can add some more hardware to that resume and solidify that legacy even further.
They'll come up now for second down and 4. In motion, it's Robinson. Off play action, it's Stafford. This one taken in by Parkinson. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45.
The drag route. We used to say this is day one install. Every single offense in the NFL has this sort of route, especially for the tight end position. And depending on the speed and the run after catch ability of the tight end, sometimes it can lead to some of the biggest gains.
Now, whistles here. Looks like one of the defenders got a head start. So, a lot of options on the table now. It's 1st and 5. Cup in motion. A give, and here comes Williams. And he's not going to get away. They'll knock him back to his own territory. They get him on the other side of midfield.
When you can get this level of run support out of your secondary, Mike, man, what an advantage for any defense. This defensive back clearly reads run, gets off his block, and he's able to take down the back for a loss of yards.
Play action now for Stafford. Out of the pressure, too much, and he goes down.
Once the quarterback leaves the pocket, his hope is that it buys him a little time to allow second reaction downfield by his receivers. But what he's not accounting for is the speed in pursuit of that defensive end. I mean, watch him catch him from behind. He closes that space a lot faster than I think the quarterback anticipated, and he doesn't have enough time to get the ball out of his hand, and he takes the sack.
So, backed up after the sack, and now it's third and long. Working out of the gun, Stafford. And that is incomplete.
Remember what they told us, Mike, leading up to this game. They said it is so critical for us to find success, especially on third down. We want to maintain possession, extend these drives. Well, the first crack comes up, and they fail through the air, and we're going to have to regroup and be able to have better success throughout the remainder of this game.
And good coverage by the punt team. They stop him before he can get any return cranked up. The Raiders offense ready to see the football for the second time. They had the field goal on the opening drive to take the early lead. See if they can improve on it here. 3-0 is our score, and it's first and 10. Second and 2. On second down, a run with White. That'll bring this to about the 25. Christian Roseboom, there on the tackle. Here's third down and a few inches. Third down, it's White. So it'll be first and 10. They'll scrimmage at the 33. From the gun, it's O'Connell. Open man, that's Trey Tucker. And he's down on the other side of midfield. Mark him at the 48-yard line.
Well, so often we see quarterbacks standing in the pocket, holding it, seeing if they can create something downfield. Well, not that play. That play was simple. Snap the ball to the quarterback, spit it out into the hands of your receiver, and let's see what he can do.
So they come to the line for first down and 10. Here and a penalty. Somebody moved early up front. Now O'Connell fires complete to Harrison Bryant. Second down and 8. O'Connell to throw. That's caught. It's the tight end, Brock Bowers. And they'll take this down inside the 35.
And you see the rookie tight end, Brock Bowers, pick up the first down. Mike, of all the tight ends that I've watched in college over the last, call it, 10 years or so, I'm not sure if I've seen a more dynamic, ready for the NFL tight end than Brock Bowers. I mean, two-time Mackey Award winner, 700-plus yards each of the last 3 seasons. He can get downfield. He can make tough catches. He can run with the ball after the catch. I mean, there's not a lot this guy can't do, and I think he's got a shot to be that next big-time young breakout rookie tight end. The best quarterbacks don't see the rush, they feel the rush, and that's exactly what this guy was able to do here. He's able to escape the initial pressure and immediately realizes, I got some space out in front of me. Picks up a solid gain here on first down.
Blitz overwhelming the offensive line, and down he goes.
They probably would have been better off just handing the ball off to the running back, Mike, because when they used him as a decoy, nobody fell for it. By the time he finished his fake and got his head around, the defense was all over.
They need the 24-yard line as they come up for third down. To throw is O'Connell. Oh, and that throw not able to be pulled in. It's incomplete. Looks like he may have got a little ahead of himself there. And it's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, we sit up here all the time. We try to break down why certain plays work or don't work. Well, this one's not real tricky. I mean, he just simply needs to catch the ball. I mean, that close to the first down chain, he just catches that ball and turns up field. They extend this drive. He's got to come over to the sideline, take a deep breath, tell his guys, hey, man, that's on me. And he's got to go out and make that next play because his team's going to need him to play better as the rest of this game continues.
Following the made field goal, and he sends this kickoff away. Very good kickoff, returnable from the four, and this will work out quite well. He'll get it all the way out to the 30-yard line. The Rams offense ready for their second possession. The deficit, 6 points. So a touchdown here would be mighty nice for the offense. See what they can do on this drive. First and 10. Here's Stafford. Huff brings it in left side.
This is a great example here of just not getting too complicated as an offensive coordinator. Who's one of your best players on the field, and how do you get the ball in his hands?
They'll come up here on second down and 5. They go play action with Stafford. That'll be caught by the running back, Williams. And they'll hold him to a gain of just a couple and sets up third down. Now Stafford. It's complete. He's got caught. And he will have the first down. The drive will continue after a pickup of 8. So a big third down hookup takes us to the break. It's the Raiders with the early lead. And we're back at SoFi in SoCal after this. Here's first and 10. That'll be taken in. It's DeMarcus Robinson. They'll work now on second and 4. On the play fake, here's Stafford. This one caught by Parkinson.
And that
down. It will be a gain of 8.
There's this misconception out there, Mike, that in the NFL, you have to run the same amount of run plays as you do pass plays. And as you're seeing in this drive, you can fall on one side of that coin a little bit more as long as you're able to remain effective and efficient. So far, their passing game has dominated here early, and that last pickup leads to a first down.
He'll let this go. Deep shot for Allen. And that is incomplete.
And that sideline just cannot believe their guy did not come down with that play. I mean, that's as easy as it gets. I frankly don't blame him. I mean, that's a play at this level you just have to make. Your teammates are dependent on it.
They'll try again. It's 2nd and 10. Stafford to throw again. That is caught. It's Robinson. And he'll be very close to a first down. Won't quite have enough, but now a much more advantageous spot.
It may not have moved the chains, but with what they were dealing with there on second down, that's a really nice pickup, because now it opens up your play call sheet on third down, where it's a little bit more manageable.
Stafford now on third down. And that is incomplete.
It's one of those balls where the quarterback wishes there was a string. The second it came out of his hand, he wished he could just pull it back, because from the moment it left his hand, that looked like a sure interception. And the only reason it wasn't, because the defender just flat out dropped it.
Here we go on fourth. Stafford. And he's going to have the Rams' first down. Well-designed play to pick up 16 and move the chains.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They clearly have a mismatch in their favor, and every time they've looked his way, he's continued to make big plays. If I'm this coordinator, I think I'm giving him one more shot and see if he can push this thing over the goal line and come away with 6.
On the move at the 14-yard line, it's 1st and 10. Again, it's Stafford. He pulls it in around the 5. And he's close to another first down as he's brought down just shy of the marker. A good spot here, 2nd and 1 yard. They'll throw once more. Here's Stafford. And he'll take it on in. 2-2 at round. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Joshua Cardy comes out now for the extra point. The kick is good. And the Rams move out in front by a point. It's 7-6. Here's Cardy now. He'll kick it away following the touchdown. Abdullah now to return. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The Vegas offense ready to get rolling again. The deficit is 1 as they'll search now for that go-ahead score. And 10. They'll start on the ground, and here's Madison. And he'll take this to about the 28. Braden Fisk is there to bring him down. Throwing on second down, O'Connell. The pass is caught by Turner. And that'll go for a gain of 7. And it's going to set up third down. Going to try to pick up the first down with his own lead. And that call will not get it done. The defense ready, stopping him behind the line of scrimmage. It sets up fourth down.
The idea here for this offense is you're not really thinking necessarily touchdown. You're thinking first down. Let's get a fresh set of downs here and reset. But in this case, they suffer a loss, and it brings up fourth down.
On fourth down, last year's All-Pro punter, A.J. Cole, on now for the Raiders. Oh, but he cannot get away. Great job down there to hold him to a short return. Rams offense ready to take over possession of the football. Their lead is just a point as they begin it on this drive with first and 10. They'll start this on the ground. It's Williams. Not much there. Maybe a yard. Here's a second and 9. It's another run here for Williams. He's bottled up after a gain of a yard. They need 8 as they come up for third down. From the shotgun, it's Stafford. Throw right side, held in by Cup. He's out of bounds, up beyond the 40-yard line. That's his third catch of this first half, and good enough for a first down.
So far here early, Mike, the key for this offense has been their ability to maintain possession by converting on these third downs. It's going to be a big storyline the rest of the way. This defense has to find a way. When they force third down, they got to get off the field.
Set to go now on first and 10. They'll run it with Williams. He's beyond midfield to the 45. Stafford. This one is caught by Robinson. Here's a second and 12. On the give, it's Williams. And he only managed to pick up 3 yards. And that leads to third down. A shotgun snap to Stafford. He gets it into the hands of Atwell. And he'll be stopped short of a first down, and that will necessitate a call to the punt team. It's fourth down.
When you throw the ball short of the sticks on third down, you're relying heavily on the yards after the catch. So give credit to the defense here. Once the ball carrier had the ball, multiple guys around him, corralled him, take him down short of the sticks.
And we will not have a return here. This one angled out of bounds. The Raiders offense getting those helmets back on, ready to head out for their next possession. They'll do so with first and 10. Turner goes in motion. The drive starts with a run by Madison. To the 35, and that'll move the chains. It's a first down.
Second down at these distances, Mike, you pretty much anticipate a pass, and I think that's what the defense was lined up thinking. In this case, they leave a little too much room on the ground, and the offense is able to pick up a first down.
On first and 10, here's O'Connell.
This was on the O-line at all. I think the quarterback is holding on to the ball too long. You know what they say, Mike? Sacks? Those are quarterback stats.
Work to do now as they come up on second and long. They run with White. He'll move this one ahead to the 31-yard line. Cameron Curl up from the safety spot to make the tackle. Third and long. Here's O'Connell. He'll set up the screen to White. Really stopped short of the first down, and that will necessitate a call to the punt team. It's fourth down. Here's A.J. Cole now, as he's on the punt for the second straight drop. Now, fair catch is made, and it's just inside the 15-yard line. Here come the Rams as their offense trots back onto the field. They'll begin inside their own 15-yard line. So a lot of real estate to cover. It's first and 10. Play action. It's Stafford. This one complete to Atwell. And he's going to be out of bounds, and that will take us to the 2-minute warning. The break the huddle coming up now for first and 10. From the gun. Here's Stafford. And that ball incomplete over the middle.
So as halftime looms, Mike, they have to find a way to capitalize on this drive right here and make sure they end the half with some sort of points. Now, that incompletion, not ideal, but at the very least, it stops the clock. Catch your breath, get back in the huddle, and this next play, it's got to be a gotta-have-it best play call.
That one on target to cut. And he's going to be dropped after a pickup of about 5. Here now, third and five. Throwing again is Stafford. Open man, right side, he's got it. And the defense can't come up with a stop there. Gain of seven and a first down.
This play is actually really well defended here. But I'll tell you, Mike, as you know, my philosophy is the tight end is always open, and this just supports my case.
To the air again, Stafford. That one, it's on target, but it goes as an incompletion. Looked like he had that one in his grasp, but unable to hold on, and it will be second down. Working out of the gun, Stafford. Work in the middle of the field, but that is incomplete. So after back-to-back incompletions, it is now third and 10. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that is incomplete.
Throughout this entire game, we've really seen this quarterback operate very efficiently, not only being able to spread the ball to multiple playmakers, Mike, but really complete a high percentage of his passes. So can't let that last incomplete break what's been a really nice rhythm so far.
And no run back here. Fair catch taken at the 17-yard line. The Raiders offense and their running back Zamir White heading onto the field. They'll start out first down and 10. O'Connell to throw. It's a pass he say he should have had. Instead, he does not, and it brings up second down. From the gun, it's O'Connell.
See a bunch of his guys hitting him on the helmet, but I can promise you they're saying next time you got to come down with that one.
And that one shut down pretty quickly. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage. Nothing more. Here's the punter now. He's on to punt for the Raiders. His kick hangs up, and the fair catch will be taken beyond the 35-yard line. Matthew Stafford and the Rams offense getting set to go again. And he has done everything you could ask of him coming into this one. He's spread it around, hasn't taken many chances, and potentially on his way to a big game throwing the football. Ball rests at the 37. It's first and 10. Stafford now. This one taken in by Parkinson. And they'll have it across midfield down at the opposing 46-yard line. They'll come up here first and 10. Back to throw is Stafford. And the coverage right there. This ball knocked away. It's incomplete.
It's his ability to change direction. He's able to go from his back pedal to then driving that route fast enough that he gets to the ball immediately as it arrives, and he's able to knock it down.
They'll try again here, second and 10. Now it's Stafford. His receiver on the impact. He's done it. Now whistles. Timeout. 3 seconds left in this first half. So on comes Joshua Cardy to try this field goal. This will be from 47 yards. Cardy's kick is good, and the Rams extend their lead to 10-6. So we have reached halftime, and it's a 4-point game. As we'll send you over to Orlando, our EA Sports halftime report with the coach, Jonathan, all yours.
All right, Mike, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our halftime report. The Rams got a nice throwback performance from their veteran quarterback, Matthew Stafford. He has a touchdown pass, and that amounted to the only touchdown of the game for either team thus far.
First half played out a bit as we expected. We'll see if there's a surprise coming up. Both teams set to go, and the second half is underway. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. The Rams offense ready to get going again. They'll have it first in this third quarter. The lead sits at 4. So we'll try to add on to that. This drive begins with 1st and 10. They send the tight end in motion. And is caught. It's Robinson. And will be taken down all the way up past the 45. First set of downs to work with. It is 1st down and 10. There's Pat Mann again. Another catch. They'll come up now for 2nd down and 4. On the ground, this is Williams. And he'll maneuver his way down to the 44. Robert Spillane spills him there. They'll look to pick this up 3rd and 1 yard. He'll try to run for it with Williams. And he's going to have 1st down. They're able to convert on 3rd and short, picking up 4. Cup in motion. Stafford now to throw on 1st down. Here's a screen set up to Williams. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up 2nd and 5. throw. Stafford. Right back to Odell. Stay connected again. That'll be a short pickup. That's not enough for the first down. Now a third and two. Play action now for Stafford. Into the hands of Allen. Out of bounds, but in business. They mark him down near the two. That is a big play for LA. And even 30 yards.
Everyone talks about all the physical qualities to play quarterback in the NFL, Mike, and of course that's a given. But it's really the cerebral approach to the game that separates the best from everybody else. And I think both of those things were on display there, as he did not only a great job of finding the vulnerabilities of the back end, but then once his guy was there, it was that arm talent that...
Under pressure, and down he goes! They've got him back at the 10.
To play in the NFL, you got to have a short-term memory, because regardless of whether the previous play was good or bad, they're going to line up and snap it again. And in this case, really nice job bouncing back. They put the bad play behind them, force the sack in the ensuing play, and they're right back on track.
Move back to the 10. They'll try here on second and goal. From the shotgun, it's Stafford. A lot of chances on that one. It was bouncing around, but it falls incomplete. A nice drive. This is the ninth play coming up. Can they cash it in on third and goal? In motion, it's Robinson. Now Stafford on third and goal. And this is going to be incomplete. That is a letdown there. Pass looked to be on target. No catch. And now fourth down.
So you're a couple inches away from, instead of celebrating a touchdown with your boys on the sideline, you're trotting back to the huddle with your tail between your legs. And that's the fine line between success and failure in the NFL. And the reality is, he knows it, the sideline knows it, the huddle knows it. At this level, you've got to make that play.
Back out following the main field goal. He'll kick this one away. Abdullah now to return. And he's down at the 23, and that's where the offense will take over. The Raiders offense trotting back out for their first involvement of this second half. They'll be looking to answer back. They trail 13-6 and start this one with first and 10. And that's the way you want to run it on first down. A gain of 7. Here's a 2nd and 3 forthcoming. A give, and here's White. He'll get this up close to a first down, working it to the 33-yard line. He'll need much. It is 3rd and inches. Now O'Connell. That's into the hands of Tucker. He's got 13 yards on the catch there. Good for a Raider first down. shotgun. O'Connell. That is intercepted. Picked off by the former Florida State Seminole.
I think anytime you find yourself trailing in the second half, Mike, all offensive play callers fight the urge to chase those points. They tend to get a little bit overeager. They tend to push the envelope sometimes a little too far. Those turnovers, they only make the deficit grow, not shrink. Now, there's a lot of football left, Mike. They can still get back into this. They just have to be a little bit smarter about which risks you're willing to take.
Here's first and 10. Play action, Stafford. Who else? Another catch for his favorite target. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up second and 5. Well, sent in motion here. On play action, it's Stafford. This one, caught by Parkinson. They'll get maybe 3 out of that one, and it's going to set up third down. Play action. It's Stafford. It's complete. He's got a 19-yard pickup there. Good for a Rams first down.
Well, there's not a lot to this route. Man coverage, and you got a drag route. Give him a little something off the line and go. Win with speed. Good accurate ball on the front shoulder pad allows him to pick up the rest after the catch and leads to a big game.
They'll throw once more. Here's Stafford. And they're going to be set up now as he's brought down at the 5-yard line. A couple of big plays, one after the other, and now it's first and goal. Stafford to throw again. Incomplete, but a late flag comes in. Looked like he might have gotten there early. So that pass interference in the end zone puts the pressure on the defense. It is first and goal from the 1. They'll try to run it with Williams. And looked like he may have had a lane, but the defense shut it down quickly. He did not get in. It'll be second down.
This defense is able to get the hold here on first down, Mike, but they might have to do it 3 more times. I think if I'm this offense, I'm saying this is 4 down territory. I've got 3 more shots to gain 1 yard. Here you go.
Good blocking, and he's in. Tyler Higbee. Touchdown, LA. On comes Joshua Carty for the extra point. He gets it to go, and the Rams will extend this third quarter lead. Here's Hardy now. He'll kick it away following the touchdown. Abdullah now to return. And their drive will begin at the 30-yard line. The visitors' offense getting things in order as they trot out for this next possession. They trail by two touchdowns, so the time is now. Gotta get that rally going. It starts with first and 10. Drive begins with a run by White. They'll mark him down up at the 44-yard line.
The ability to be effective on first down, Mike, it just makes everything else easier. In the event you do have to face a third down the road, there are usually a lot more manageable situations, a lot easier to convert.
From the gun, it's a run with Madison. And he's going to be brought down, but not until he gets inside the 35.
Watch the running back's patience here, Mike. He's slow, and then he hits it. That's the key here. If he goes too fast, their linemen aren't ready yet. Really well executed. Great run.
So they come to the line for first down and 10. Here's O'Connell. Looking middle, and he's got Myers. And they bring him down inside the 25-yard line.
Points have certainly been hard to come by in this one today, Mike, but it seems like this drive has been what they've been searching for. A little bit of rhythm, the ability to sustain. Now they got to finish. Now they got to capitalize on these first downs and go finish with six.
Man in motion here is Tucker. O'Connell to throw on first down.
Performance so far in the first half, Mike, and they're going to try to figure this out here in the second half and try to gain some momentum. Figure out what's going to work, where are our matchups, and let's go try to put the drive together and get some points, because so far this has been a struggle, and they just cannot get anything going for the end.
And that'll be intercepted by Tre'Davious White. And the Rams are going to take over at their own 28-yard line.
Well, Mike, once again, this drive, it ends the same way their last one did, walking off the field following an interception. Now, you're hoping this is more momentary struggle than it is a trend, but as hard as it is to do, they need to get calmed down. They need to reset, because their offense cannot operate at a high level if they don't have confidence in this passing game.
The Rams' offense starting to trot out for this next possession. The lead is a couple of touchdowns as this drive kicks off. First and 10. Out of the gun, Stafford. A throw left side, but it's incomplete. Try again. It's second and 10. Stafford. Pass to Robinson. He's got it. And a good job rallying to the football. Holding just a gain of a yard and sets up third down. Working out of the gun, Stafford taking the deep shot here with Robinson. That one is batted away, incomplete. No separation that time, tightly defended. It brings up fourth down.
If you want to be a top-notch NFL DB, of course, yes, the athleticism is a given. But it's really, you have to be instinctive. The instincts are what allow you to maximize those physical skills and You saw him on full display right here, leading in the big-time breakup.
A fair catch called, and he's going to take it out beyond the 25-yard line. The visitors' offense and Aiden O'Connell heading back onto the field. And this defense has really had their way so far, intercepting him twice, forced into a number of bad throws. And generally, the D has just made it tough to operate all game long. First and 10. They'll start this on the ground. And here's White. And he'll take this forward for about 3. It's second down. It's O'Connell. To the left side, it is caught by Myers. It's a gain of 12 there. First down, Vegas. So, 3 quarters now in the books. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL. On EA Sports. Fan in motion here is Tucker. Quick throw, taken in. And he's not going to be able to get away. Very good coverage on the perimeter. It goes down as a loss of yards.
The quick passing game in the NFL, Mike, is so dependent on yards after the catch. You got to generate space with the scheme, and then it's up to the receiver to do the rest. In this case, nice job defensively, because this guy couldn't even get back to the original line of scrimmage.
And he'll be very close to a first down. Won't quite have enough, but now a much more advantageous spot. Here's 3rd and 2. On play action, O'Connell. He gets that one complete to his tight end Bowers. And they're going to move this ball inside the 25-yard line.
Okay, so now you pick up that first down, Mike, but now there needs to be a sense of urgency. You know you need to score twice. So this one, ideally for the offense, results in a touchdown. But either way, this first score of the two needed needs to be fast, because you need every possession you can here late in the fourth quarter.
On 1st and 10, here's O'Connell. He'll go right back to Bowers. He's got it again. And he'll be taken down.
And this is what the offense needed. Now, after that last completion, you still trail here in the fourth quarter. You need scores, and you need scores fast, so they cannot take their time. I wouldn't be surprised to get them right back up on the line of scrimmage and try to score here now that it's 1st and goal.
They'll run with White. They'll come up with nothing there. Fortunate just to get back to the line, and that'll set up 2nd and goal.
Sometimes there's just nowhere to go, right? We ask these running backs, Mike, to do a lot of work, find space, create something out of nothing. Well, this time, he was able to create nothing out of nothing.
One more time, it's White. And he keeps the legs moving, able to get it down inside the 5. Plays at their disposal, but they'd love to get it right here on 3rd and goal. To throw is O'Connell. And this play. It's incomplete.
They went for it all on that one and just a little bit off. Ball winds up hitting the ground. They've got to move forward. The opportunities are out there. Better execution, better location, and they got some big plays in their future.
3 for 3 in the game, as this one is also good. And the Raiders will cut into that lead. Out is Carlson following the made field goal, and he sends this kickoff away. Here's Smith to return it, and he's brought down right at the 25-yard line. The home team's offense and Matthew Stafford heading back onto the field, and he has been masterful so far leading this offense, keeping the mistakes to a minimum, on point with his passes, generally one step ahead of the defense all game long. From the 25, they'll go to work. First and 10. Now it's Stafford. That one pinballs around, but it is incomplete.
What did he tell us in our production meeting this week, Mike? He takes such great pride in his coverage abilities, and after that play, it's pretty clear why.
Second down, it's Stafford. That'll be caught by the running back, Williams. And he's going to be dropped after a pickup of about 5. Backfield empties. 5 receivers in the formation for third down and 5. From the gun, here's Stafford. That is brought in. And he is out of bounds, but not until he's inside the 40-yard line. That is a big play for L.A. 31 yards. The 39. Here's a first and 10. Throwing again is Stafford. This one taken in by Parkinson. And they bring him down, but not until they get inside the 30-yard line.
So often we see a team that's milking a 2-score lead get very conservative, especially in the fourth quarter, but not this coach. He says, all right, I might have a 2-score lead. I want to make it 3. He's trying to put as much pressure on his opponent possible here down the stretch late.
He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete. Williams, and he'll be very close to a first down. Won't quite have enough, but now a much more advantageous spot.
So when you're evaluating the impact of a team's run game, like, I think it's important at the end of the game to look back and say, okay, how many yards did they run for? But more importantly, when did those yards come? Did I run for those yards in the fourth quarter, which typically means I had the lead? That's the sign of a successful run game, as opposed to getting a lot of meaningless yards.
And it looks like he's got enough for the first down. Let's wait for the mark. Yes, that run, that's enough to move the chains. They'll go again with Williams. Lane fills quickly. Only managed to get this to the 14. Here's a second and 9. From the shotgun, it's Stafford. He'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
The relationship between the pass rush and the pass coverage is critical. The better you rush the passer, the more pressure you can take off your coverage, and that's a great example why.
Trying to keep a drive alive, gonna have to convert on 3rd and 9. Now it's a bootleg with Stafford. Looking middle of the field, it's complete. And the Rams are gonna have a 1st and goal coming up. They try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
That might end up being the backbreaker right now. This defense desperately needed to get off the field and give their offense a chance to cut into this 2-score lead. But instead, they now got to defend a fresh set of downs. And as you look up at this clock, they might be running out of time.
They'll run. It's Williams. And he'll just get up inside those big bodies up front. And he's in. Tyron Williams. Touchdown, Rams. Cardi now to add the extra point. It's up and through. And the Rams will open it up even further here in this 4th quarter. Here's Cardi now. He'll kick it away following the touchdown. To return, Tyreek McAllister. And a solid run back there. He'll get this out past the 30-yard line. The visitors' offense ready to take over once again. Things not looking good. But see if they get the turnaround going here. They'll start this drive with 1st down. O'Connell. The pass is caught by Turner. And they will bring him down on the other side of midfield.
Didn't take them long to get now to their opponent's side of the field. I like the idea of starting this drive with some explosive pass plays. That's going to open everything up, both underneath in the passing game and on the ground. So big play to get this drive off to a fast start.
That one into the hands of Turner. Brought down after a gain of 6 on 1st down. They'll work now on 2nd and 4. Now O'Connell. That's a short one. Caught by Bowers. And they'll whistle him down, but not before he picks up a 1st down. After a gain of 7.
The drag route is such a good way to get the ball early into the hands of your tight end and take some pressure off the quarterback and give him an easy completion. The size and the athleticism allows them to try to pick up more yards, but do it after the catch.
He'll find his running back, White. And this takes him into the red zone. He's brought down inside the 20-yard line.
Anytime you have a running back like this, it's more about just how many ways can you get the ball in his hand. He's had a great game today so far on the ground. Now they're starting to find ways to get him the ball through the air, and that is a handful for any defense.
He brought this underneath to White, and no chance to turn and go. That one good for just a couple.
So often for a defense defending the passing game, the most difficult guy to account for is the running back out of the backfield. So a really nice job here bringing him down before he has a chance to pick up any yards after the catch.
To the end zone there, but it is incomplete. We're going to try to pick this up on third and eight. He's got Myers on the completion. And a good short tackle right there. It stops him a good distance short of the marker. It sets up fourth down. O'Connell to throw. We hit the two-minute warning. Set to go now on first and 10. The drive begins with a run by Williams. Not much happening there, just a short gain. Here's second and 9. Cup in motion. On the carry, it's Williams. Maybe a couple there. It's third down. Out of the gun, Stafford. And that is incomplete. Cooper Kupp was the intended receiver. And it's going to lead to fourth down.
Really nice job there of not only tracking the ball, but then putting yourself in position to make the play. And that's step one. I promise you, step two on that sideline, his secondary coach is saying, hey, next time you can get your hand on the ball, let's try to come away with that takeaway.
Get forward a few yards on the return, and that's where the offense will take over. The Raiders offense about ready to take over once more. They'll begin with terrific starting field position. It gets going with first and 10. Here's O'Connell. Over the middle, that's the tight end, Bowers. He's close to a first down, to gain a 9. Nice pitch and catch on first down. Second and a yard. Blitz coming, he'll throw it. He gets this one to Tucker. And they'll take this down inside the 35. a fresh set of downs to work with. It is first down and 10. Off the play fake, it's O'Connell. That one caught by Tucker. And this takes him into the red zone. He's brought down inside the 20-yard line. They're at the 17-yard line now for first and 10. From the gun, it's O'Connell. And he'll finally eat this one. He'll go down. They got him in the backfield. So it's a win here for the Rams. And right away, you can point to the turnover battle. Always key. Tells the story so often. It did here again today. Their offense didn't turn it over at all. They finished on the plus side with the takeaways. As a result, they're going to come away with the victory.